Hello, guys and girls, this is Mihiwei, and today I'm going to give you a little glimpse of what is hopefully going to be a real gem of indie gaming history. And yeah, it's Upvote Miner. As you can see, the menu is not detailed right now. And yeah, this is an alpha version. We have to expect some crashes, bugs, the usual stuff. And yeah, let's take a look. I had to lower a lot of these settings to in order to make it recordable for me. I'm also only recording in 720p now, because otherwise the frame rate is just too low that you, well, you don't, wouldn't want to see a deer show, wouldn't you? And yeah, let's check the controls. Left click, use a selected item, inventory, 1 to 9 for a quick slot. Yeah, that's pretty much so far like Minecraft. Pick up items and drop items. And we can use the mouse wheel to change the size of our construction shape, which seems pretty cool. We will play around with that a bit. And then we can teleport upwards if we get stuck and teleport back to spawn position. Okay, cool. Let's hop into it. Whoop. Jump, jump. Okay. Yeah. Please look. Okay, we can pick these up. And yeah, then we got some tools here. Well, shovel in our hands. Let's start digging a bit. Cool. Yeah, there is no blocks in this game. And yeah, let's see what we can do with that stuff. To tell you a bit about Upvote Miner. I'm sorry, Simple Miner was the previous working title. Upvote is a gaming, yeah, we could say a game developer or company, which is formed by a group of German master students in computer science. And yeah, they've been working on this project for quite a while now. I think it's about a year right now, maybe a bit less, maybe a bit more. Not too sure. Anyway, they wrote this whole engine by themselves, and yeah, we got some trees over here, and yeah, the sky looks also pretty nice. And yeah, let's see what we can do here. Let's see, we got dirt over here. Let's place it in our last slot. Okay, and yeah, can place it like this. Going upwards. Yeah, I guess it might turn out a bit difficult to build a hut here. But yeah, it also doesn't seem completely impossible. I guess as they progress to develop the game, this might get a bit easier. Also, it seems like we can also just have these circular shaped placing right now. There's no cubes or rectangular shapes that we can place stuff in, except for these blocks that we were given at the start. But I think these are a great thing that we can use to show the physics that are implemented in here. And yeah, to show these, let's try to place a block like here and then see how that slides down the hill and point comes to a halt, which is pretty nice. And okay, there's one thing. I somewhat want to make this cylinder here fall to the side and then roll somewhere. Let's see if we can manage to do that. Maybe if we place it over here. Oh yeah, as you can see, stuff is not getting processed if you are too far away. which is now is generating terrain. And okay, that didn't work out too well. Let's try this again. Oh, and again. Yeah, in a previous try to record, I actually made it happen that it rolled somewhere and just wanted to replicate that, but unfortunately, I don't seem to have too much success right now. I'm sad. Okay, now we got it placed like this, and okay, I can manually get it to roll a bit at least. And yeah, so great physics so far. And yeah, you can push around these blocks. And one other thing I discovered when I, yeah, so you can also don't have necessarily like a full amount of cubic meters. Here is 18.6. And if we click on it, we see it's stone of type 9. So I'm just assuming that there is so far at least 9 different types of stone, which is pretty cool. Yeah, that stone over there, for instance, looks a bit different than this one. And yeah, I'm not going to try to find all different shades of gray right now, but yeah, other than that, let's try this wall over here. I'm just trying to find a nice location where it could possibly roll for a. Does this go down a bit? Well, let's just try it. Just see. Oh, on here. Oh well, it stopped already. Let's try to find a spot where we can have it roll a bit farther. Well, this is where we just were. Let's just have it roll down here. I'll just go a bit down the hill already, so we can see more of it. Wow, this thing is getting quick. And the tree stopped it, and oh, now it got out of sight. There it is. Yeah, I wish I could fly or something to keep up with this balls. Oh man. Yeah. So this is all procedurally generated. You have some kind of seed, and then you. Yeah, the world just gets generated according to that. So possibly if we get a way to create a world with a certain seed, we can also, yeah, if you just find a great seed where you have something awesome, you can just share the seed with other people and tell them how to get to that point or something like that. Just as in Minecraft. And yeah, this thing is slowly but surely going to come to a halt, most likely. I hope so, and, otherwise the physics engine would not be that great after all. But yeah, it's looking great, isn't it? And well, oh, I think that's going to roll for a while. Let's not bother too much with that. Let's go back to the surface, and then there's another thing I want to show you. Yeah, we tried to place some dirt by hand before, but these things here, these drones, are made to make this a bit easier for us. So if we place one of these over here and one of these over here, can I place more? No. Okay. So now, in theory, what should happen is if I place something over here, it should get cut off at that border. Yeah, like this. So you can, well, it doesn't work perfectly, as you can see here, but Yeah, in theory, you have get an idea of what the developers come up with to let you place like flat walls and stuff like that. So I think they have a lot of great ideas also for upcoming content. One thing I would li really like here is if you were able to actually place anything against that. Well, not really physical existing wall, but yeah, just pl being able to click here to place something here to make it a bit easier. But yeah, as you can see, this is becoming a somewhat flat wall over here, and yeah, would of course look greater with stone, but I didn't really feel like digging tons of stone. And yeah, unfortunately, there is not really a way to reclaim these drones right now, which is also a bit of a flaw, but I think that will come somewhat soon. Or you can just enter some building mode, maybe, and then just set up markers like that to place down your stuff, so you can not only have this wall, but maybe also one over there to really place a wall in the middle here. Stuff like that. I think we can be curious what is going to happen. And yeah, I really recommend you guys to check out their YouTube channel for more video material and also their homepage to see more development going on. Especially if you understand a bit of coding, you c might get an idea of what they are doing right now and which problems they are facing. And yeah, if you also w wants to get all updates like directly from them as quick as possible, make sure to follow them on Twitter. All these links will be in the description. And yeah, I think for now, I'd say thanks for watching and see you next time.